Wharton offers a diverse undergraduate education, not limited just to business. A quarter of your required coursework is outside of Wharton in Penn's 11 other schools. 23% of Wharton students study abroad, 27% pursue minors, and 28% graduate with more than one undergraduate degree from Penn. If you have your sights set on Wharton, this video will tell you everything you need to know to get accepted into Wharton undergrad at UPenn. Nadine here with Quad Education, helping students get into their dream college. Before we dive in, don't forget to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out on any of our college admissions editions. Let's start by looking at the most recent class profile information. This way, you'll be able to compare your stats to those of accepted students to help you gauge your level of competitiveness at the school. In the most recent cycle, approximately 55,000 students applied to UPenn, with 2,500 making up the incoming class. The middle 50% scores reported by enrolled students were 34 to 36 for the ACT and 1510 to 1560 for the SAT. Interestingly, nearly one-third of the admitted students engaged in academic research during their time in high school, and over 80% engaged in community service activities. The most recent Wharton undergraduate class is made up of roughly 500 students who come from over 60 countries around the world. 68% of the class identify as students of color, and 15% of the class are first-generation college students. To understand how to get into Wharton, let's start by going through what you'll need to apply. Penn's Central Office of Undergraduate Admissions handles all admissions decisions for Wharton, so you'll need the following items. Number one, a complete Common App or Coalition App. Number two, letters of recommendation. You'll have to submit three letters of recommendation, one from your school counselor, one from a teacher who taught you, and one from another recommender. This other recommender can be another teacher, or it could be a non-academic recommender, such as a supervisor, coach, or mentor. Number three, supplemental essays and personal statement. You'll need to submit three Penn-specific essays as well as a personal statement. These essays are used as a way for the admissions committee to gain insight into how you think, what you value, and how you see the world. Number four, you'll need your transcripts and school reports, including your mid-year and your final report. Number five, supplemental materials. Some kinds of supplemental materials that Penn may consider include an additional letter of recommendation, not from another teacher, an art or music sample, a portfolio, or an expanded resume or research abstract. Number six, you'll need the $75 application fee or fee waiver request. Number seven, you'll have to meet the testing requirements. No preference is given to the SAT or ACT. If you submit both tests, Penn states that they will pay attention to the higher score from either test. Keep in mind that UPenn is currently test optional, but make sure you refer to the most up-to-date information on the admissions site when you're applying. And number eight, your interview. What's neat about Penn is that more than 90% of applicants are offered an interview depending on volunteer availability. These interviews are conducted by Penn alumni volunteers, and the interview is meant to be more of a two-way relaxed conversation as opposed to a strict interview. But of course, even though the interview is more of a conversation, your interviewer will be sending a summary of your discussion to the admissions committee. So make sure you still present your best self and think about engaging questions to ask your interviewer. Now that you know exactly what you'll need to apply to Wharton undergrad, how do you make sure your application is impactful and stands out from the rest? Follow these tips. Take the most challenging classes offered. Your GPA matters, and Penn states performance in high school is the single most important factor in the student selection process at Penn. However, Penn understands that not all high schools follow the same grading and ranking policies, making it challenging to compare applicants' high school experiences. That's why the university seeks applicants who take the most challenging courses available to them and achieve high grades. You won't be penalized of your high school's lack of course offerings in the admissions process. However, if your school offers the IB program, AP classes, or dual enrollment, it's in your best interest to pursue one of those rigorous curriculums. Next, take the ACT and ACT seriously or consider a retake. Although UPenn paused the standard admission testing requirement in the most recent application cycle, you do typically need to submit ACT or SAT scores. These scores are important because they show your college readiness and your ability to handle the rigor of college-level instruction. Next, you want to take charge with your activities list. Your activities list shows the admissions committees your interests and time commitment outside of the classroom. When you complete your list, order your activities to show which are most important to you or which are the ones that you spend the most time doing. Penn wants to know how much time you spend doing each activities as well as your specific responsibilities. Make sure to list a whole array of activities. These could be related to school, your family, a part-time job, or summer and community experiences. Remember, Penn isn't looking for anything specific, although it would be helpful here to list any activities related to business, leadership, or any initiatives that you've taken. Next, you want to choose your recommenders wisely. You have to provide those three letters of recommendation. For your teacher recommendations, be sure to ask an instructor in your junior or senior years who taught you in a core course. UPenn says, consider obtaining a recommendation from a teacher in your area of academic interest. We don't, however, recommend submitting letters from two teachers of the same subject area. For Wharton hopefuls, this may be teachers who instructed you in math, English, business, or any other related subject area. Next, you'll want to tailor your essays to Wharton. Because every student must apply to the University of Pennsylvania generally, the supplemental essays are your opportunity to show why you're a great candidate for Wharton undergrad. You must explain how you will explore your academic and intellectual interests at Wharton. To write a masterful essay, research is your first step. Is there a particular course in the Wharton curriculum that inspires you? Are you excited to jump into one of the 18 concentrations? Think about how the program offerings relate to your interests and how that exploration will help you achieve your goals. The second essay asks, how will you explore the community at Penn? Consider how the Penn community will shape your perspective and identity, and how your identity and perspective will shape this community. This is an excellent opportunity to write about clubs you're interested in joining, how your unique experiences will add value and differentiation to the community, and how you hope to be influenced outside of the classroom. A great starting point here for your response would be to check out the more than 45 Wharton clubs. Well, that's a wrap. Hopefully now you'll be on your way to getting accepted at Wharton undergrad. Thanks for tuning into this video. Make sure you subscribe to our channel for all the latest and greatest on the college application process. Cheers to your success.